started, sir.
Yeah, it was started. It probably took some time. Check your chat box. I have put the URL for this website. If you browse it, you should be on this page. Yes.
Yes.
Now the version that we are going to need for the version of Angular that we are again going to use is not either of these two. These two versions don't support Angular 12 that we are going to use. Okay, so you have to click on other downloads option here below 16.14.0 LTS. Click on other downloads here. You should get to this page. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Now on the top again, it is version 16 only. So that is not the one that we are looking for. Scroll down and look for previous releases option. Do you get it?
Yeah.
Find this, click this. Here it shows different versions. We are looking for a version that should be same as what I am having, 14.18.2. So go to the second page and see if we have there. No. Third page, no.
You can just
fourth page,
14.18.2 in the search bar there.
In the sixth page, we have it, right? On the sixth page of this screen, you have 14.18.2. Do you get it?
Yes, sir. You could just have searched there.
Yeah, that is also okay. Search will also okay. The point is, we should be having this version. Click on downloads here. Which file you would be downloading? There are so many.
Windows 64 zip or 7 zip.
This one, Node v14.18.2-x64.msi. This is the file you should be downloading, which is actually an installer. So once downloaded, you can start installing. And your node will get set up. So click this, it will start downloading here. Just under 30 MB, so should not take much time. And go with the default settings, just next, 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 and get it installed.
No need of picking automatically install the necessary tools, or should we tick that box?
Which tools it is asking for? Can you share the screen?
It isn't asking for any tools. It's a statement, automatically install the necessary tools. Note that this will
just
be
share
also
share your screen. Let me see what it is.
Yes. This one.
Wait. No, just click next. Install. Just restart command prompt. And type node-v.
It's installed.
Okay, so guys, once the installation is finished, just restart your command prompt and then try this node-v so that you should be able to see the right thing. I'll wait for another 1 minute. You should all verify your installation like this. Is it done for all?
Yes, sir.
Just raise hands who are done with this.
Mine is done and installed, but when I'm typing node-v, it's again showing the same
error.
Close
the command prompt and restart it and then try.
Okay. I need confirmation from around 6 more people. Sudarshana, Siddharth, Siddhant, Sakshi.
It installed, sir.
Yeah. We are able to verify it by using node-v, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What about Sakshi, Urmila, Imant?
Yeah, I raised my hand. It's done.
Okay. Fine. There are a few more things that need to be verified. You can put your hands down. The next thing you have to check is the version of Node Package Manager tool. This is equivalent of NuGet Package Manager that we had in .NET. So for JavaScript, we have npm for Node. Type npm-v, npm space dash v, and press enter and see what version you get there.
It's 6.14.15.
Version 6 or later is okay.
Same.
Right? If all of you are getting version 6 or higher, that's fine. Minimum requirement is version 6.0.0. Okay. Next, we need to install the Angular framework. So here you say npm You can say install or you can say I also. I or install is one and the same thing. And then hyphen G or global install means for all users on this machine. Name of the framework that you are looking to install. So say at Angular. It's a library actually which will be installed. / CLI. At. If you just put this, it will install the latest current version of Angular. We don't want that because that might be unfinished version. I'm looking for tried and tested and stable version. That is 12.2.13. Press enter.
Sir, I got I not recognized as an internal or external command.
NPM space I you have given, right?
Oh, okay. Got it.
What was the issue?
I did not write npm. So now it's done.
Right. The main command is npm. Right, so it takes some time and gets the package for the Angular framework installed. Yes.
So for this, would you like to share anonymous usage data? Do you have to press Y or N? Yes or no?
You can say yes, there is no problem. It is more about, you know, the feedbacks which go to the Angular team in case if there is any crash. I hope you have put the version number correctly.
Yeah, it's 12.2.13.
Correct. Along with at the rate, right?
Yes.
Let me put this command in the chat box also so that there is no error.
So we put N to it, now how to change this setting? Would you like to share anonymous thing? We have to put N.
Yes, Y or N. You can put Y, there is no problem with that. Done? Again, how much time it takes depends on your internet connection speed. Because everything is getting downloaded from internet only.
So can we check the Angular version as well?
We'll do that. Just a moment. So if you want to actually check, just go ahead and put the command ng for Angular and followed by space followed by version. You get the version here for Angular CLI, for Node, the package manager npm, and what type of operating system it's all working on. Got it?
Yes, sir.
So everyone verify whether you have got the correct Angular CLI version installed, Node and Package Manager versions installed properly or not. Command is ng space version. Just raise hands quickly who are done till here without any issues.
Sir, I have installed the version, like it asked me to click yes, I clicked yes, like I didn't see the screen now.
Can you come again? I didn't get your question.
Yeah, like in installation, it asked for yes or no option. I clicked Y and after that, I'm unable to see the screen. Like. Minus again in the command prompt, like in the same thing.
Okay, can you share your screen?
Yes. Minus three. Can you
see? Okay, just type ng space version.
ng. Just
12 points.
Yes.
Okay, I can see 22 hands raised. Sri Lari, Shiva Kumar. Sakshi. Okay. Just lower your hands. The further thing will require us to browse to the folder where we have been saving our projects till now. So just open File Explorer, go to Start, type File Explorer, locate your
can project. You share your screen?
Is it not visible?
No, not yet.
Okay, there seems to be some lag with internet.
Yeah, now it is.
Okay. So just open File Explorer. In your case, I guess you just have C drive, right? Just go to the folder where you have saved all of your work till now. In my case, it is D drive, desktop backup, 5th March 21, Providence 5, demos. Click into the address bar here. The whole path will be selected. Just right click on that selection and click on copy. Copied the path?
Sir, it must be the folder where we have made all the projects, right?
Yes, correct.
Okay.
That's where you are going to put the Angular project also, right?
Okay, sir.
Copy this path from address bar. Now, in my case, it is on D drive, so I need to type D colon and press enter. You need not do that. Your stuff is all on C drive only, right? I believe that's the case for all of you. Yes or no?
Yes.
Just type the command CD and right click on this command prompt. The copied path will automatically be pasted. And once the path is pasted, just press enter. Your prompt now must be showing the path which you have copied. Yes? Yes? Everybody done?
Yes,
till here?
Sir.
Now here we want to create our first Angular app, which actually is going to interact with our API that we have written for interacting with the department table. So directly the department API is what we are targeting here. Okay, so here type the command ng new is the command to create new Angular project. And then the name of the app that you want. So I'll prefer to call it as Department API Client dash ng app. Dash ng app, just to understand that this folder basically represents the Angular application. Just like for most of the projects, we have used some prefix CS underscore, MVC underscore, API underscore. For Angular app, I'm putting it at the back end. You can put it at the front end also, no problem. NG app dash department API client will also do. It is just a name. Usually for Angular apps, this NG app is put at the end. That is a convention. That's why I put it there. But it's not a rule, remember. Done. Make sure before writing this command and proceeding, you are at the right path. This must be the path where you want the project to be created. Then only write the command and press enter.
So can you explain again how to copy the path?
Just go to the file explorer. Browse to the location where you are saving all of your projects, all of your demos till now, and then copy the path from here. Got it? So it might be in your documents or wherever it is.
Yes, sir. After that?
After that, here you just need to type CD space. And then right click on the command line, it will automatically paste the path and press enter.
Sir, it asks, would you like to add Angular routing?
After this command, right? So just wait.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I hope the path issues are resolved for all. Give the command like this, use exact name so that there will be no mismatch in the code. We'll save our time, right? ng space new space the name of the app, where I have chosen the name as department API client dash ng app. Press enter. We'll start creating the Angular application. May come up with some questions. We just need to read those questions properly and answer. I believe this is what you're talking about, right? Would you like to add Angular routing? Yes.
Yes, sir. Should we?
So type Y and press enter. We need Angular routing. We may not use it immediately, but in the future versions of the application where we come up with multi-table solution, we will require the routing there. So if we keep our application ready with it, it will add all the dependencies automatically. Otherwise, later on, manually, we need to add those dependencies. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes.
Next, it is asking for which style sheet format would you like to use? The formats it is showing is CSS, that is cascading style sheet, we know, most of us know probably. Then we have SCSS, SASS, and LASS. These are the new languages created to create the style sheets. Little bit simplified compared to that of CSS, but the point is these are new languages, you need to learn them. If you have already learned, you can try with those languages, or else simply go ahead with CSS. And for making the selection, you just need to use up and down arrow key. Whichever is highlighted one, that is the selection. So I'm keeping CSS only selected, that is the default. Press enter. It just starts creating your project.
Sir, after installing the packages, it says Git is not recognized.
That's okay. You can ignore that. Git is actually a code repository tool, right? So if it is not configured on your machine, it will give you the error because Angular assumes you would be using Git. But that's not a compulsion. You may be using a different code repository also. So if it is giving error, just ignore. So once it is finished, it should be back to the prompt. You just need to make sure that there is no error as such. And that Git also must be coming as a warning, not as an error. Am I right?
Yes, it's just a warning.
Make sure there is no error. And your project is created. Here, if you issue the dir command and press enter, there must be a directory created by the name of the application that you gave with nginew. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Just type cd and type the name of your application. Department API client dash ngr. There must be a space after cd and press enter. Now your path must be updated to show the folder name also included for your application. Yes.
Yes.
Done, everybody? Till here?
Yes, sir. Sir, I'm facing like everything is done, but as it is also getting synced with the OneDrive, so I'm facing an issue over there that there is a file which has a hyphen as the name. So it is saying that the OneDrive cannot sync it. So
that's okay. That's okay.
Okay.
Only thing is there will be no backup for that folder.
Okay. Okay, sir.
But locally it will keep on working, right?
Yes, locally it's working.
Okay, so once this is done, you are inside the folder. Again, issue the dir command to see what all things it has created. There are some files and folders which are created there, right? Project is created, that means. Now the question is, how do I proceed from here? And what actually it has built for me? Is it an empty application? Is it having some sample stuff into it? That I want to check. But before that, in my application, I'm actually going to use jQuery and Bootstrap as well. jQuery used for some validation purpose by Bootstrap, not by Angular. jQuery is basically a dependency of Bootstrap. There are some Bootstrap features which are built on top of jQuery. So I want jQuery and Bootstrap packages to be added as well. So here, once you are inside your application folder, issue the command npm spy jQuery. npm space I space jQuery, and then followed by space hyphen hyphen save. So there will be a copy of this that will be saved into your project. Along with a copy being saved at the machine level also. So next time when you want to use jQuery, you need not download it from internet. jQuery is installed the same way I'll install Bootstrap. Bootstrap is a theming framework based on CSS and JavaScript. Here I say npm I bootstrap. -save.
So what does this hyphen hyphen save do?
It basically creates a copy into your project along with a copy being saved at the machine level. Something like in my documents. So that if any other project is created which wants to use this package, it need not be downloaded every time from the server. There is a local copy, it will use that itself.
Okay.
Done. Two commands we executed inside the folder, npm I jQuery hyphen hyphen save, and then followed by npm I bootstrap hyphen hyphen save. Yes, done. Done, everybody?
Yes, sir.
Now we want to see what it has built for me. I want to start serving this application. So here I say create the instance of the development server of Angular. Ultimately, it will be deployed on some web server only. Just type ng serve, ng space serve, and press enter.
So it asks, would you share anonymous usage data, yes or no?
Yes. So the compilation going on for whatever it has built automatically. Looks like there is some sample created.
So there is a very big error for unhandled express exceptions finding modules devkit build angular package json. Do I need to delete and reinstall the whole thing?
No. Can you confirm what path you are able to see?
Path is department API client NGN.
No, right from the beginning if you can tell me.
I'll just share my screen, I think.
Yeah. Just a moment, here the server is started for me. It is showing me that the application is available on this URL. Right, here is the complete one with the protocol. I just copy this and go to the browser, open a separate tab, and here I paste the URL and press enter. This is what the output I should be getting. So some sample app it has already created, which has got lots of documentation about Angular, lots of link for the advanced documentation and the official Angular website as well, angular.io. Right, some tutorials are there, exactly how I proceed. All the information I can find here itself. That's nice. Okay, so this is what your target must be. Once you do ng serve and your application starts, you get the URL, copy that URL, put it into a separate tab in the browser and see what you get. Output must be this. Yeah, now you can share your screen.
Okay, sir.
Is it visible, sir? This is what came. The result of
yes, it is. Command. How come it is showing C sharp folder here? Can you put DIR?
Up is the folder that I named there. It's the folder I have created everything inside.
No, it should be there in the API client, no? So just type cd space department API client dash ngr. DIR. You have node modules folder there. You have package.json also there, right? Did you install Bootstrap and jQuery here?
Yes, I had installed.
Just issue the command again. ng-i jQuery -- save. Oh, sorry, npm, it should be not ng, it should be npm. And repeat it for Bootstrap. Okay, wait, Bootstrap 5.1.3 require a pair of Pauper.js, but none is installed. You must install per peer dependencies yourself. Okay. Let me see if I also get this. Just a moment.
Sure.
Okay, so you have to put one more command. If anyone is getting this message, like this Bootstrap 5.1.3 requires a peer of Pauper.js core, something, something. In that case, just issue the command npm I at pauper.js / core. Yeah, exactly. The whole name till the version. Do it with -- save as well. So reissue the command, put -- save at it. If you're not getting that message, that is okay. Now say ng space serve.
It is showing the need to install Pauper, but there is no error. So should I?
Later on when we modify our application, there will be issues. It won't be showing as error. The thing is, the UI may not look proper.
Okay, so
few things may not work.
I'll install it then.
Yes. So just stop your server by pressing Ctrl C, install Pauper, and then again say ng-serve. Okay, Tushar, just issue the command npm space install and press Enter. It looks like some of the packages were not installed properly. So this command will detect all such missing packages and will install.
Okay, sir. Should I do anything after the installation is
completed? Wait. Let this be finished.
Sir, can you please tell the command again for Pauper?
Yes, ng space I space the name of the Pauper.
Sir, npm, right?
Yeah, npm, right. Tushar, can you paste it in the chat? Just check it, guys, in the chat. Basically, this Pauper is used for some pop-up menu features. the look and feel of the pop-up menus may not be as per required if Popper is not installed. Okay.
Sir, mine is compiled successfully, but like the localhost, that web ID, when I'm putting it and entering, it's saying security issue, like it's not secure. The website is not secure.
You are giving that 4200 port number only, right?
Yeah, yeah, 4200 port number.
Which browser you are using?
Oh, now I got it. Now I got it. Sorry. Okay. Yeah, previously it was not happening. This time I did not write.
Compilation was still going on, maybe because of that.
Okay.
Sir, installed jQuery and Bootstrap. It just showed me about the vulnerabilities. Then do I have to do ng serve or?
Just do ng serve, ng space serve.
Yeah, I did that. Then I'm getting a lot of errors. It is showing the module.
Is it saying module not found or package not found?
Module build failed, it's telling. Cannot find module.
Yeah, so cannot find module or cannot find package if it is there. Don't worry. Just type npm space install and press enter.
But I'm not able to write anything. It's just at the last, it's telling.
Press control C and then do it.
What should I write?
npm space install. Okay. Tushar, you are still getting the same error?
It's a different and a very big error, sir.
No, but again, it is cannot find module, right?
Yeah, cannot find module. It's a different stack right now. Package of JSON here it was found, but I think something else.
Just say control C and do npm install again. Your connection probably is not stable, and that's why some of the packages are not getting installed. So you have to keep on doing this npm install until and unless all the modules are not installed properly, and that should make your application work. Okay.
Should I also install AGV package, because it also requires, it's not, it's just a warning like Popper?
No, you don't need to.
Okay.
Tushar, just go for ng serve if the npm install is finished.
So my laptop crashed just now, so I just put it on restart. I'll let you know shortly.
Okay. So just raise hands quickly, those who are successfully able to see the Angular page, the sample application.
I'm still getting error after doing ng serve. I did it twice.
Okay, can you share your screen?
Yeah. Can you see it?
Yeah, now I can. Just a moment. Just do ng install once again. Control C and then ng install. Before that, do CLS. CLS press enter. Now ng install.
ng install or npm install?
npm install, sorry. Once I start using ng commands, I usually do this mistake. ng takes over npm in my mind. Okay, now say ng serve. Still the same error, is it?
Yeah.
What it says, browser module has not been processed correctly by GCC, or is it not compatible with Angular? I will check if the newer version of the library is available and update. If so, also consider checking with the library's authors to see if the library is expected to be compatible with IE3. Seems to be some version issue here. Okay, do one thing. Press Control C. Let's set up everything from scratch. Type cd dot dot. Press enter. Now go to File Explorer and delete the folder that we created just now. Department API Client. Oh, you cancelled it.
I'm trying to delete it again.
Deleted, I guess. Yeah. Okay, now go to command line and give the first command ng new. And then the name of the application. Department API Client dash ng new, ng app. Enter. Why? And enter. Just enter. Now type cd space the name of the app. Enter. npm space I space jQuery space hyphen hyphen save. npm space I space popper.js.
Yes.
Popper.js.
Can you spell it, please?
P-O-P-P-E-R, popper. Tushara has already put that in chat. You can copy that command actually. Then again, npm space I space bootstrap rap.
Enter?
Yes. ng space build. This is only to compile, not to start. Enter. Why? Is it the same error as before?
Yeah. Last time I was not getting this prompt, but now I'm getting that. That's the difference.
Okay. Now, can you show me the first line of error? Down. Here it is. Okay, can you go to the file explorer? Copy this folder, department API client ngr, and put it directly on C drive. I'm just wondering if there is some issue related to the permissions. Yesterday also some of us got that, right?
I got that.
Yeah, so it could be the same. Okay, meanwhile, I can see only 21 hands raised. Those who are able to serve the application successfully and able to get that Angular UI in the browser, please raise hands. Remaining people. Right click this folder, properties, Remove read only first. Apply. Okay. Once this is finished, go to security. Click edit, add, everyone, check names, okay, allow all to everyone, apply. Srilahari, Vedanta and Tushar, is it not done for you?
Sir, I'm just installing node modules again.
Okay.
What should I do now?
Okay, so double click on the folder. Copy the path. Go to command line. CD. Put a CLS command first. CD. Paste that path. Enter. Now, first say npm install. Now say npm build, ng build.
So the issue was not with npm install. I had a hash in my file folder directory. That's why it was not serving.
In the name, you mean?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I removed that name. Actually, I changed the directory in which the folder was there, and it worked.
Okay. It's built, right, Abhya?
Yeah.
So remember, you have a problem with the permission, so you have to put it on C drive, right? Create a folder called as demos. Within that, you put all the programs and give the permission to everyone for that demos folder, all permissions, yeah. So that whatever you put into it, it will inherit. Understand?
Yeah.
Now just say ng-serve. So Tushar, now it is working for you, right?
Yes, it's compiled.
Great, great. Yeah, there are some special characters which are not allowed to be there in the name, especially in the path, because they have some special meaning in Angular.
Yeah, it's compiled now.
Right now, you must have the URL there. You can see HTTP yeah. localhost. Copy that, paste into the browser, and press enter. Okay. What about you, Sri Lahari, Vedant? Okay. So let's proceed. Lower your hands. Our application is up and running. Now here we need to see exactly how do we proceed with the editing of this application so that we can put in our own code, right? For that, you have to install a tool called as VS Code, Visual Studio Code. Right, so within the browser, look for VS Code download. First link which comes there, download Visual Studio Code, Mac, Linux, Windows. Click that. You can directly go to code.visualstudio.com/download as well if you want. And you know what to be installed. You just need to say download the 64-bit version, or simply if you don't know, click this. It will automatically detect what is your Windows version. Accordingly, it will start downloading. And once this is downloaded completely, run the setup, go with the default settings and install it. So while it is getting installed, maybe we can take a break.
Sir, I think so. It is already installed.
Is it for all?
When we downloaded Visual Studio 2019, so it automatically came.
No, Visual Studio 2019 doesn't have anything to do with VS Code. VS Code is a different tool.
Okay, I just checked in my laptop, so I have it installed.
If it is available, that's good. If it is not, just install it. It may be there for some of you, may not be there for some of you. Okay.
Yeah, it's not in mine. So.
Yeah, so just install it. It will take 5 to 10 minutes max. Right. So we'll take a break here. We'll resume at 4:15 and we'll see the further stuff. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.